Hello guys, my name is Mitch Romzhensky. We continue to explore the power of Angular dependency injection, and thanks to my two previous videos, we already know how Angular resolves dependencies and how we can control this process by using resolution modifiers like self, skip self, host, and optional. In today's video, I will show you how to use dependency providers, which allow you to control how Angular should create the instances for provided dependencies. We're going to cover today the next dependencies providers like useClass, useExisting, useValue, and useFactory. And also we will cover a little bit injection tokens today. As always, this video was split into different sections, and timecodes to the sections you can find in video description. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel right now, and we are getting started with dependency provider called useClass. So guys, let's quickly recap how do we provide dependencies. So we do it either in providers property of components or directive or module, or inside injectable annotation, right? So now let's imagine that we have a next case. We developed another experimental logger service, right? And we would like to test it with some certain component before to apply it globally in the application. And because we want to kind of replacement of the logger on the fly, we need to be sure that they both have the same API, right? And for this, we need to create appropriate interface, right? Which our loggers will be implementing. So I will run ngGI logger, which means ng generate interface logger, and it will generate an empty interface for us. Let's open this file and let's say that it should have a property prefix, which is a string, and the method log, which takes a message with type string, and it returns nothing, so it is void. Then we implement this interface for logger service. And now let's create our experimental logger. So I will run ng generate service experimental logger. And then we go there and implement our logger interface. And then we will add necessary fields and also the log method. So this service will do the pretty much the same thing, but it will have the string which contains this experimental keyword. Okay, so far so good. Now we can play around with dependency providers. So as I said earlier, we would like to apply our experimental logger only to app component and its children. So only node injector hierarchy would use this, and also we are not allowed to change our constructor because, I don't know, let's assume that components come from the, I don't know, separate library which has been created by our colleagues from another department, and they're all invocation, so nobody can adjust them. And this is where useClass could be a good fit. We just have to slightly modify our providers property, and instead of directly provide it, I just create the object which has at least two properties. And first one is provide, and we say that provide our logger service. And the second one is our useClass dependency provider. And as a value, we add a reference to our new experimental logger service. So it means that when Angular will create an instance of this logger service in app component injector, it will not create an instance of logger service, but it will create an instance of the class which we defined in the use class. Angular will literally do something like return new experimental logger service and provides its dependencies if it is. And now if we save it and go to our browser and check the console, we'll see that the message is coming from experimental logger service, which means that useClass was executed correctly. Also, you can do the same configuration inside injectable annotation. You just need to define it somewhere here. So, like this. And now, because we have provided in root, everywhere in the application will be used implementation of this new service. Of course, if you don't override it somewhere in child injector like we do right now in the application component. Okay, that was useClass provider, which allow you to provide alternative class implementation. But useClass has one, let's name it, feature. And it creates a new instance of the class. And if, as example, I would like to inject experimental logger service into our constructor, like this, and it will be separate instance. And our logger service here will not be the same instance of this one. So it would not be a singleton anymore. And I can prove it. I can just console log it here. I put the message if both loggers are equal, and I will just compare them. Now, if we go to the browser, we will see that it says false. But what if we want to create just an alias for the experimental logger service? So I would like to use already instantiated service, which lives now in the root model injector, because we use provided in root, right? And in this case, we should use useExisting dependency provider. And doing this, we tell Angular to not create a new instance for the service, but grab already instantiated one. So in our case, it would be taken this experimental logger service, which already exists in the root model injector. Alternatively, you can use useExisting provider inside the injectable annotation if you prefer to use tree shakeable services. Now let's go back to our app component. It could be also the case that you already have an instantiated and properly configured object and you do not want Angular to create it and use just already existing object. It could be some, let's imagine, some super legacy logger, which is not a class, but just an object with some similar interface, like, I don't know, this one. And if we provide it to use existing provider, it will fail because it is not injected and Angular will be trying to find dependency for the object. useClass also would not work because it uses operator new in order to create an object. And you cannot call the operator new against the object literal. So there should be another way. And in this case, you have to use useValue provider. And we can provide our legacy object as a value, and now Angular will assign this object to this provider. Very often this useValue is being used in tandem with injection token. And when you want to inject a non-class element, let's say some string or config object, that's example. And I would like to show you some use case for this injection token. And I'm going to create some global config for our application. So let's just create a separate file and create there, first of all, the interface which describes our config. And it will have only one property called experimental enabled, which is Boolean. And here below, there will be an application config, which is injection token with type app config. Then we have to provide a value to this token, and you can either do this as we did it before in providers properties somewhere in app model, because it's supposed to be a global config, right? And we can add object here and then provide and use value like this. But I will use another tree shakeable way. I just go back to config token, and here as a second parameter I can path an object, and like with the services I can say provided in root, and then I will use factory in order to provide a config, and it will enable experimental features. And after this you can inject it in your constructor somewhere in, I don't know, service maybe. And you can use the inject annotation for this. I will console log it in constructor for now. And if I go to the browser and reload the page, I can see that my config was injected. Okay, cool. I will remove it so far from it. And just few words about injection token and why do we need it. If you saw my first video about dependency injection, we built there some dependency injection prototype, and here we had a map where the key was a class reference and the value its instance. And because we inject not a class, we cannot use class reference as a key. But we need to have some key anyway, otherwise Angular cannot understand how to resolve it. Interface also will not work because interfaces are not existing at the runtime. And this is where injection token can help us, and the value of injection token will act as a key in this case. And I hope it is clear now, and we can move forward. The last dependency provider is useFactory. And this provider is very convenient if you do not know which service to provide in advance, and this could be known only during the runtime. And this is quite often happens when you need to configure a provider based on the value from another service or dependency injection token. So let's use our app config, which we created, and we will resolve correct logger for our application depends on if experimental features are enabled or not. So I will use this provider useFactory. The factory is going to be just a function, empty so far. Then we know that we have a dependency on our app config, so we have to provide it. And we will do it by using depth property, and we provide app config here inside the array. And once we have done, we can access it as a function argument here. And now we can check if experimental feature is enabled. We will use experimental, otherwise we use our logger service, all right? Now we can save it and check in the browser if it works. I reload the page and we can see that experimental logger was involved. So let's try to change it. I turn off the experimental feature and then I go back to the browser, and we can see that now logger service logged the message. If some of your services have dependency on, let's say, HTTP client, yeah, why not? You can provide them all in depth array, and then you can inject this in your service constructor. So let's assume that our experimental logger does some HTTP calls, yeah, like this. And then we have to inject it inside a class constructor. Here we go. And of course, do not forget to import HTTP client model into app model. Otherwise, your app will fail. So this is how you can use factories in order to make your providers even more flexible. And the last thing for today I would like to show you is the difference between useValue and useFactory. It is very often developers are confused by this too, especially who saw some construction like this. So in useValue also could be provided a function. So let's try to console log what is our logger currently. So we can see that this is our experimental logger instance, right? And now let's try to change it to the use value and try to console log it. So do you see? Instead of instance of the service, we get just a function as it is when useFactory calls this function and uses the returned value as the value for the token. So we can say that useValue has a static nature when useFactory has dynamic one. And this is pretty much it about the providers. And the one remaining things is property multi-true. But I will do this in another video, which will be released somewhere in 1 week. And there I will show you some real case where you could apply this feature. Okay guys, that was it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and now you have better understanding what is dependency providers in Angular and which problems they are solving. Of course, I would like to hear your feedback in comment section and hit thumbs up if you like my videos and don't forget to subscribe to my channel because more interesting and in-depth Angular topics are coming. And as always, I wish you a productive week, take care and see you in the future.